For the first 10 million years, our people lived in furs and fear. Kill each other with their spears. There were no cars and no careers. No one thought of right and wrong. No, all they knew was weak and strong. Hunt and gather all day long and guard their butts from dusk till dawn. One day these two hairy guys, instead of fighting with their knives, came up with a compromise and called themselves civilized. They said, me is mine, you is yours, each free to keep his own rewards. We'll plant berries, beans, and gourds and live in peace together. Now let's get this straight. You won't tell me what to do. You don't own me, I don't own you. Death to those who think they do. They may be strong, but they be few. And you and I will long survive and multiply. I'll tell you why. Natural law cannot supply a means for thieves to unify. They'll cut each other's throats for us. Others soon began to see a new thing called prosperity. All were welcomed happily as long as each one would agree. Me is mine, you is yours. We'll settle our disputes in courts. We can build a mighty force and live in peace together. Now there were still disparities, more than some folks could bear to see. So they set up charities, all sharing voluntarily. Voluntarily, that's the key word. As they grew, they formed a state to fix the streets and guard the gates. But in time, received mandates to regulate and educate. And the unionized public teachers would say, me is mine, you is yours. Our naive founding fathers' words. Those were simpler times. Let's all hand the state our swords and live in peace forever. The state would grow to dominate, to license, tax, and confiscate, to bribe their own electorate until it fell beneath its weight. Now they're just a swirling mob with stones and spears. They've got no jobs. They hunt and gather, kill and rob, and all was lost 'cause they forgot. Me is mine, you is yours. The law all law should reinforce. We can take no other course and live.